Hello friends, welcome to my channel Financial Literacy with AV. My name is Abhijit Biswas and I am on a mission to help laymen get financially literate. To be a part of this mission, just pause this video and subscribe to my channel. Also hit the bell icon so that every time I upload a new video, you get notified. In this video, I am going to show how EMI is calculated and how a loan amortization schedule is prepared. I'll also show how the EMI amount will change as a result of increase or decrease in the interest rate. So let us get started. Suppose you have taken a loan of rupees 30 lakh. And the loan tenure is say 20 years. So if 20 years is the loan tenure, so how many EMIs you will have to pay? 20 into 12. 240 EMIs you will have to pay. Suppose annual interest rate at present is 8%. So your monthly interest rate will be 8% divided by 12. That is 0.67%. And what will be your EMI? EMI amount can be calculated using PMT function in Excel. So we'll be using PMT function in Excel. First, we'll have to select the rate. So here I'll have to take the monthly rate. NP here is nothing but number of EMIs. Present value is nothing but the loan amount. Bracket close, press enter. Right, that is the amount of EMI. That is every month you will have to pay 25,093 rupees approx to repay the loan that you have taken. Now, if you observe, I put a minus sign before the PMT function. If I do not put the minus sign, say if I remove this minus sign, then this answer will come in negative, right? Because that is how the software, that is the Excel, is programmed. So just to avoid that minus sign, we put one minus sign before the PMT. That's it. Now let us learn how to prepare the loan amortization schedule. So your loan tenure is 20 years, which basically means you have to pay 240 EMIs. So EMI stands for equal monthly installment, right? So how many months I will have? 240 months. So let us write that 240 months. First type 1 and 2, then you can just drag it till 240. Yes, till 240 we need. So at the beginning of month 1, the amount due is the loan amount that you have taken, that is 30 lakh, right? What is the interest that you will have to pay in the first month? Very simple, loan amount multiplied by the monthly interest rate. Loan amount multiplied by the monthly interest rate. I will just give absolute reference for the monthly interest rate because this rate I will be using for other months as well. What is your EMI amount? EMI amount is 25,093 rupees approx, right? So how much principal you have repaid in the first month? Total EMI that you have paid is 25,093 rupees approx. Out of that, 20,000 rupees you have paid on account of interest, right? So the remaining amount, that is 5,093 rupees approx, you have paid towards repayment of principal. Now what is the ending due amount? That is at the end of first month, what is the amount due? That is nothing but the amount due at the beginning minus principal repaid. So ending due, that is at the end of first month, the amount that is due is 29,94,906.8. Now whatever is the amount due at the end of the first month, that becomes the amount due at the beginning of the second month, right? Then again you need to calculate interest on this amount. So interest on this amount will be basically this amount into 0.67%, right? That is what we have done. EMI amount will remain the same. The same way again we can calculate what is the principal repaid. Principal repaid is nothing but the EMI amount minus the interest payment. And in the similar fashion we can calculate what is the ending amount due. So ending amount due is nothing but beginning amount due minus the principal repaid. Once we have completed the calculation for the second month, what we need to do, we just need to select these sales and double click on this plus sign. Our loan amortization schedule is ready. See, at the end of 240 months, the amount due at the end is zero. That means we have repaid the loan. So this is how we prepare a loan amortization schedule. Now suppose the interest rate that we pay on any loan is generally a floating interest rate. What do I mean by floating interest rate? Floating interest rate is an interest rate which keeps on fluctuating based on the benchmark index rate. So RBI along with the Monetary Policy Committee quarterly reviews the interest rate, and they can change the interest rate if they so desire, right? So suppose after paying 12 EMIs, interest rate is changed, and interest rate is changed to say 8.25%. That means interest rate has been increased by 0.25%, right? Now, this will impact your EMI calculation, right? Let us see how. Now, what will be your revised EMI? To calculate your revised EMI, you will have to fill in the other columns as well. Say, for example, paying 12 EMIs, what is the amount of loan still payable? So you can find that out from this loan amortization schedule. So after paying 12 EMIs, the amount that is due at the end of 12 months is 29,36,590 approx, right? So that is the amount still due. So you can just enter that amount here. After paying 12 EMIs, this is the amount still due. So this is the revised loan amount. What is the revised loan tenure? Since you have paid 12 EMIs, 12 EMIs means 12 months, 12 months means 1 year. So out of 20 years, 1 year is gone, right? So remaining tenure is 19 years. So if 19 years is the remaining tenure, so remaining EMIs will be 19 into 12, that is 228. And interest rate we have already filled in, so monthly interest rate will be 8.25% divided by 12, that is 0.69, and we can calculate the revised EMI. Again we'll be using PMT function. Rate is 0.69%, NPR is 228, PV is the revised loan amount, bracket close. This will give us the revised EMI. Now see, previously EMI was 25,093 rupees approx. Now the EMI has increased to 25,545.67 because the interest rate has increased. Now this will impact your loan amortization schedule also. So let us make those adjustments. So you still have 29,36,590 rupees approx payable, right? So you'll have to calculate interest on this amount. So this amount into the interest rate. So now the revised interest rate is this. So I'll just drag it here. So revised interest rate. So this is my interest payment in the 13th month. And now the EMI amount is changed. So my revised EMI amount is 25,545.67. So this is my revised EMI. Okay, so principal repaid, same way we can calculate EMI minus interest payment, and amount due at the end, same way we can calculate beginning amount due minus the principal repaid. Next, come to the next month, that is month number 14. So amount due at the end of 13th month will become amount due at the beginning of 14th month. That is fine. On this amount, again, we'll have to calculate interest. So I'll just drag this to this revised interest rate. Okay. And your EMI is now 25,547.67. That is correct. This is your principal repaid, that is EMI minus interest amount. And this is the amount that is payable at the end of 14th month. Once this is done, you just have to select this row and double click on this. So your loan amortization schedule is revised, and you can see again at the end of 240 months, amount payable is zero, right? So this is the change that will take place because of increase in interest rate. Now I will also show what happens when the interest rate decreases. Now suppose after paying 24 EMIs, that means after 2 years, interest rate is now again changed, and interest rate is decreased to say 7.75%. Okay. If interest rate is decreased to 7.75%, what will happen? Now, again, you will have to fill in. So let us see what is the loan amount. That is, what is the amount of loan, or how much of the loan is still payable after paying 24 EMIs. So let us go to the amortization schedule and see. In 24 months, if you see, after paying 24 EMIs, still 28,69,823.55 rupees is payable, right? So here I will write that amount. So that is going to be the revised loan amount after 24 months. This is the amount. Okay. Now, what will be the loan tenure now? So since you have paid 24 EMIs, that means 2 years have gone by. So from 20 years, if you removed 2 years or deduct 2 years, so 18 years is the revised tenure, right? So 18 years means 18 into 12, that is 216 remaining EMIs, right? And your monthly interest rate will be 7.75% divided by 12. This is your monthly interest rate. And your EMI will be PMT, rate is 0.65%, NPER is 216, and PB is 28,69,823.55. Okay, so you see now your EMI gets reduced to 24,677.73. As interest rate decreases, your EMI amount also decreases. Now you will have to adjust your loan amortization schedule because of the change in the interest rate, or because of the decrease in the interest rate. So let us do that. So from 25th month onwards, we'll have to make the adjustments. So at the end of 24th month, amount payable was 28,69,823.55. So that will be the amount payable at the beginning of 25th month. So that's fine. Interest needs to be calculated on this amount based on the revised interest rate. So I'll just drag it here to reflect the revised interest rates. Then EMI amount is also changed. So we'll have to now use the revised EMI amount. This is the revised EMI amount. Okay, so this is done. Principal repaid calculation is fine because this is nothing but EMI minus interest payment, and amount due at the end, that is also fine. That is nothing but amount due at the beginning minus principal repaid. Okay, so the amount that is due at the end of 25th month, that becomes the amount due at the beginning of 26th months. That is fine. Again, we'll have to modify the interest calculation. So I'll just have to drag this to the revised interest rate, monthly interest rate. Okay, so that is done. And your EMI amount is now 24,677.73. That's correct. This principal repaid calculation is also correct. That is EMI minus the interest amount. And amount due at the end, that is also correct. That is amount due at the beginning minus principal repaid. So once you have done the calculation for the 26th month, just select this row and double click on the plus sign. So your amortization schedule is adjusted and ready. See, at the end of 240 months, your amount payable is zero. So this is how we prepare loan amortization schedule, and I have also shown you how to adjust your amortization schedule as a result of increase or decrease in the interest rate. Hopefully you have understood. If you have understood, then please type in the comment box you have understood, or you can just simply type super clear, or if you have any doubt, then you can ask your doubt in the comment box, or any queries that you have with respect to this, you can add. And you can also mention the topic on which you would like me to make the future video, right? Thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed the video, please do subscribe to my channel. And if you like the content, do share it with your friends or to anyone who can benefit from this particular video. Thank you. Have a nice time ahead.